So what we're doing now, what do you want to do next?
Check the signs of the time.
Okay, you see any breathing?
No.
Any chest of sun arising?
No.
Any signs of life?
No.
No less than?
Five.
Hair open, close, and begin. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Let's do breath. Okay, and back to the chest. Okay, your defibrillator's just arrived. Okay, first thing you want to do when you get it? Turn it on.
What's with you?
This is a training device only. No shock will be delivered. Remove foam from person's chest. Attach pads firmly to person's chest, as shown. Analyzing rhythm. Everyone stand clear. Everyone stand clear. Check that your shock is on.
Stand clear.
Stand
clear.
Shock advised.
Actually, what we do is we put it
right here.
All right, just wait.
Okay.
Everyone stand clear.
All right. Please, you guys, look at your shock. That's all.
Begin 5 cycles of CPR.
Wake up, wake up, wake up.
Shock advised. Charging. Everyone stand clear. 1 minute and 30 seconds. Everyone stand clear. Push the shock button.
Yep.
1 minute and 30 seconds of CPR remains.
Be serious. Go, Glenda. You go, girl.
Gibson, don't you dare play that.
No, you don't stop. You don't breathe. Keep going until they tell you to stop. Just keep going.
And you keep doing it until the machine tells you to stop.
2 minutes.
Okay. All right. Got it.
Remember, if you're into your sixth cycle and it has to hold you to stop, it just means you're going to move fast. That's fine.
Why don't you need to fire out?
30 seconds.
What is CPR? It's chest compression?
Yep. CPR is like you're giving breath also.
And you're giving breath also.
CPR is cardiopulmonary resuscitation.
They're saying just to do chest compression?
No, who's saying?
Him?
Compressions and breath. You want to get breath?
I was, and then they told me
that. Oh, no. 30 compressions
and 2 breaths.
They
made me kill the guy.
30 and 2 breaths.
I know, that's what I was doing. And then they told me only chest compressions.
Okay.
That's all I get for listening.
Oh my gosh. It's not really easy. You get it in?
7.
No, 7.
Yep.
He's breathing.
It's American law protection.
Yeah, you're leaking some, but it is moving.
Right.
Okay, so then pack
the shock button. Shock delivery. Begin 5 seconds.
Dr. Reese.
Okay.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So, second group. Again, from the time you guys lived that first shot to what came back on, that was only 2 minutes to see. Okay, now, at the end of 2 minutes.
He's dead.
Yes, you do press. Yeah, I'm silent. Okay.
Oh, my God.
Okay, CPR. All right, ladies and gentlemen, CPR is cardiopulmonary resuscitation. Heart, lungs, basically, when you get your defibrillator, if you weren't breathing before, let's say this was hands-only CPR, because you don't want to breathe it to someone you don't know, but once you get the defibrillator, you're going to get that pocket mask. So now you want to breathe in. All right, so you give your 30 compressions and 2 breaths. The breaths are important. The compressions are more important than anything else. Because with the compressions, you're at least buying time while you're waiting for the defibrillator and the barrier device. All right, but once you get the defibrillator, you definitely want to be breathing into them because you'll have that, and because you want to get oxygen in. When we breathe in 21% oxygen. We exhale 16. So we only need 5% to survive. So if I'm breathing in 16%, 11% is coming out. That's why it's more than 30 compressions, 2 breaths, and the oxygen.
32.
Now, at the end of this 2 minutes, the machines came back on. With some of you, the machine said no shock advised, which means one of two things are happening. He's breathing, all right, he's moving, in which case I don't need the shock, but the machine stays on and it's going to reanalyze every 2 minutes, all right, and we leave it on because in case that he does go out, I'm ready to go. But in this case, did you see any breathing?
No.
No. Did you see any signs of life?
No.
So you can't deliver a shock because it could be, in that case, there's no electrical pattern. You're going to keep going with good CPR for another 2 minutes, and then it will reanalyze the heart. Because you saw no signs of life. The rest of you had said deliver the shock, which means your victim was still in that shockable rhythm. You deliver the shock, you go back to your compressions. So again, it all depends on your victim.
So it's random. I mean, this training, that one is it randomly says
one or two.
One or two. Okay. Yep. That's why I wanted to.
Yep.
How often do you need updated training?
Every 2 years.
Every two years.
Now, it got a little noisy in here. At one point, we had 8 machines going along.
Everybody, everything is said. Right. Friend, right.
We do that on purpose. Because let's say you're here in the church, you're here in this room, all right, and somebody goes down. This person goes down. I'm here, I'm doing CPR. I've got the fully automated AED. Alright? If it's the point that you can't hear your AED, let alone yourself, stop for a second. You in the white, I need you to sit next to my machine, tell me everything it says. You in the stripes, I need you to get everybody back, clear out this area. With him, he's now my ears. He's telling me everything this says. Right, because if I'm dealing with the fully automated AED and I can't hear it, who can get shot? Me. I turned her into the chief of police. She's going to stop pushing people back. Because you got to realize, you're down here. Everybody's looking at you to see what's going on. I stopped. I pointed to her. Now everybody's looking at her.
Yeah.
All right. So she, hey, close those doors. Get those people out. Close those, you know, make it safe. Make it easy for you. Mm-hmm. Because if you are dealing with the fully automated AED, you can be a bit. Okay, questions?
What we have is a fully one, right?
You have a semi-automated.
Semi-automated.
So yours, you have to push that button.
Okay.
Okay, pack your pads, pack them up, put the pads back against the folders and against each other. All right, we're going to do choking and we're going to be done.
I have a question regarding an infant. I remember back then when we were CPR with a child that used to hold the bat.
That's the choking.
Yeah.
We still do only
that.
On infants.
Yeah, we still do that.
Yep.
Cold.